Here comes Linda Willemsen, I think, once again. Taking a little time to recover and now going. Willemsen, bronze medal in the individual time trial. And now digging in once more. She's done this on the last lap, Sean, but she looked a little bit uncomfortable to me by the time she'd got to the final climb. America reacting once more. The United States of America, one, two, three, four people in here. Linda Willemsen, well, that's a very significant attack by the bronze medalist in the individual time trial. We've got the gold medalist and the silver medalist in here as well. And again, United States of America trying to shut this gap down. They're doing the majority of the work in the last two, three laps.
Yes, well, they are doing the big, big majority of the work. And Willemsen, on the last climb there, she was a little bit off, 14 seconds behind, and she knows that on the climb she's going to have difficulty matching the big attacks. And the tactic is to try, get out of this group. And we could see there was a little bit of a down moment where it slowed down a lot, and she decides to go. And it's the tactic to go for if you're not feeling good enough and strong enough to be able to stay up there in the final lap on the climbs.
Willemsen, Stevens, Cantele, Pooley, Corsett, Willock, Zeluti, Verbeek, Brandley, Jansson, Gerdezo, Arndt, Cheatley, Kukenskaite. Willemsen strung them all out. They've taken the bell. This is where it all is going to happen now. back to Claudia Hausler. But Linda Willemsen has gone for this one now, because she knows she's going to have trouble when she's going to try and out-climb somebody. She's all by herself. She's going to have to use her time-trialing ability, Sean, to do as much as she can. And once again, it's the ever-brave Evelyn Stevens who's shutting things down. But Kristin Armstrong, to me, looked like she's beginning to suffer.
Yes.
Who knows,
yes, and I think everybody is suffering a bit, but looking back on the climb, the last one, Armstrong looked to be quite strong. She reacted very well when Marina Voss went in the attack, so difficult to know, and we will see, I think, the clear answers the next time up the climb. And everybody, I think, is a little bit under pressure at the moment. It's just the fittest of the fittest will survive here.
Right at the front is Evelyn Stevens, churning away the pedals, trying to shut down the gap on Linda Willemsen. She's got Naomi Cantele just sitting right behind her. Then Emma Pooley, it looks like, of Great Britain. Ruth Corsett of Australia. Then Kristin Armstrong of the United States of America. Nicole Brandley is in this group for Switzerland, and they'll be very pleased about that. Terrific ride that Stevens has done. And Zeluti seems to have made it up towards the front as well, and Pukenskaite as well. Hard to shut this woman down. Bronze medalist in the individual time trial. Riding for Denmark. Having her best world championship. She did a good individual time trial last year. But some big names who are no longer in this race. Nicole Cook withdrawing from the race early on. Withdrawing not so long ago, but suffering very early on. Kristjana Sørde having no luck at all. So the defending world champion, just not her day today. Turning around in towards the final ascent of this first hill. And Sean, I mean, can Willemsen hold off these better climbers behind it?
No, I think it's going to be difficult. The advantage, as we see there, it's only maybe 5 seconds, 7 seconds, and it's not enough, because they can see out there, and anybody who, go in the attack here can come across that gap so quickly, as we see it's over already, with Emma Pooley just setting the pace once again on the front.
She's going to have to be careful. Emma Pooley, this is the time. Everybody's looking at each other. Kristin Armstrong on the far left-hand side. She's got a teammate with her. Is it Abbott she's talking to? Oh no, is it still It might be Abbott, because right to the back, having done the job and trying to gasp in air, is Evelyn Stevens, number 36 there. Catherine Cheatley's having a very, very good run as well, number 83 from New Zealand. I would expect to see something, maybe a little bit of attack for her, but she just follow in attack. Christian Armstrong gets towards the front, the beak of Belgium, Pooley of Great Britain, Emma Johansson from Sweden, and again the United States of America try and break the other climbers. Emma Pooley reacts, Verbeek behind, Johansson of Sweden. Johansson has been my favourite for a title, I've got to say. I think the podium, I don't know, could you call a podium out of these?
Well, difficult, depending on what happened on this climb and the next one. You know, I think
if it
comes down to a sprint, well, then it's going to be major difficult to call the podium here, because with, you know, this group of, what, 12, 15 riders, I cannot see them all staying together. But again, you know, sometimes you would expect a lot of action in the final lap, and, you know, the tactic, they just mark each other out, and nobody really go in the attack, and they could a lot of them stay together.
Because Nicole Brandley of Switzerland taking up the pace in the front, who's going to get shed out the back here. Brandley digs in hard then, the local rider. Pooley still towards the front. Christian Armstrong, that characteristic high cadence, she gets into the wheel of Nicole Brandley, easily up to the back wheel of Armstrong goes Johansson Vos, number 14 for the Netherlands. And Pooley looking as though she's suffering here. Emma Pooley, who's done so much work, is sliding back through this group. Naomi Cantilly moves up, as well as Gerda Zoe. Ruth Corsett still there. Right at the back is Mara Abbott. And this is looking not good for Emma Pooley. The super climber from Great Britain seems to be suffering, or maybe she's just saving herself. I don't know, Sean. I mean, she can't let people, maybe, what do you do if you think you've got a little bit of effort still to do? Do you leave it? Italy are now forcing the pace on. They've got more than one rider in the break, of course. This is the advantage for them.
Yes, and the advantage, it's maybe come into force later on, but on the climb it's really individual, as we see Gudero going in the attack here. And I don't think Emma Pooley can allow anybody to, you know, get any advantage here. It's, you know, it's so important that you stay with the big favourites, because the effort you have to make to get across, she's just suffering. I think she's in major difficulty at the moment.
I think she's in major difficulty. I think it's, this could be the point where Emma Pooley sees her chances disappearing from her. I mean, still got another hill to go, but Gerda Zoe pushes towards the top, and ominously, Marianne Vos is riding up to the rear wheel. She's an extraordinary rider. Christian Armstrong and Naomi Cantilly join her. Well, this is a brilliant ride by Christian Armstrong, regardless of what happens in the future. She's looking behind, and Armstrong just slips in behind Cantilly. It's a brilliant ride by Armstrong, 37 years of age now. She's just won the gold medal in the individual time trial, and she's had to ride really hard in this race.
Yes, she's made a big effort there after the mechanical she had, and you know, she still seems to be quite comfortable. But equally, Cantilly has done a very good job here, because she went out in the attack, and you know, she's matching the best riders up front at the moment.
Pooley and Johansson are the next two over, then Stevens, Corsett, Verbeek, Cheatley, Brandley, Zaluti. Well, this is an absolutely crucial time for Pooley and for Johansson, and again the dig goes off the front. It's Gerda Zoe, or is it Cantilly? Cantilly looking, and another big attack as Gerda Zoe, I think, comes from behind their group.